This is the western end of the Solent, and there's Yarmouth, and here is Newtown Creek, which is where I am now. So I'm just going to go up and have a little look around and explore.
You can see that it's got very narrow entrance. Apparently it's £15 a night. You use one of the visitors' buoys, but if you drop an anchor, then it's free. This western end, you'll have to put up with the gull colony if you park at this end, which is quite noisy. The eastern end is much quieter, and there seems to be about 2 metres of water there. Plenty of places to drop a hook. And apparently you can get in and out at any time.
Newtown is a cracking little estuary. Actually, it's probably the nicest spot in the Solent. I'm told that in the height of the sailing season, getting an anchoring spot can be a real challenge, but this early in the year, it's wonderfully peaceful. Newtown was once the biggest settlement on the Isle of Wight. Its docks could handle vessels of up to 500 tons. Trade, salt and oysters were the financial foundation of the place. Sadly, it was thoroughly sacked by the French in 1377, and it never really recovered. Too hard to defend, apparently. At one time, there were plans to build a nuclear power station here. Fortunately, that didn't happen, so it's now a lovely, quiet backwater. It's the equal of the best Essex has to offer when it comes to sensuous mud, sinuous channels and supine scenery. Don't miss it if you come to the Solent. You'll feel very differently about the place after visiting here.
Flood, not much, but I mean there's coming slight westward flow. I really can't work out the tides of this place at all. My plan today is to go from here, Newtown Creek just across here, and up the Beaulieu River, which is supposed to be one of the most beautiful rivers of the Solent.
Sadly, it belongs to Lord Montague Beaulieu, and he likes to take money off people, even for dropping a hook, which upsets people greatly. Really, toffs, you just need to have a little think occasionally, is the language, but bloody Nora, man. What do you think, you own the place? Well, of course you do. So, this is Solent in a very different mood from what it was yesterday. Here comes some wind. Going to be chuckling along nicely any second now. I'm just going to type in some coordinates into the GPS so I know where I'm going, so I know where I'm drifting. Absolutely beautiful. the zephyrs across the Solent. This is, I mean, the western end of the Solent, which is really the nicer bit. It's less developed. It's quieter. In this world, in this country, the further west you go, the nicer it gets. Wetter it gets, not much difference in the Solent, but generally, you know, Wales, West Country, Western Islands, more beautiful. More rain, though. You can just see these little zephyrs of wind across this patch of water here, and it's flat, it's lovely. I'm looking forward to getting my new sail. This one is a bit tired. Just need to move the truck forwards a little bit because we've got a wobbly edge here. Just drifting along here at 1.9 knots, probably. Flow is against me. I'm doing very badly with these Solent tides, very badly indeed. I have to say that she is an astonishingly well-balanced boat. You have, my darling, impeccable manners. The tiller, tamer. It's not the best one I've ever invented, but it'll do. It does cut the cockpit in half, which is a bit of a nuisance. But she's fine. Pretty good. She's been sailing like this now, keeping a good balance to the wind for about an hour. I haven't touched that. So here we are at the entrance to the Beaulieu, just coming through here, these two bits here. It's red. Job. And ahead of me is a Mobo going slowly. You're going very slowly. Well done, Mobo. 5 mile an hour speed limit up here. So. It's not often that you see a small, kind of ordinary wooden boat, a boat that could easily have been rendered in plastic.
From the 1740s, the Beaulieu River was home to a naval shipyard. There were actually three Beaulieu ships at Trafalgar. The Navy was at the top of its spending power at the time. In a way, the Navy was England, and England was the Navy. So these shipwrights were top-notch.
Just run out of water, so what I'm going to do is to run back down the river until I can't hear the road anymore. I suspect the best place will be down where the river opens out a little bit. There's a kind of salt marsh place. I don't think I can see any houses from there. These are nice houses, but I'd still rather be somewhere that I can't be seen.
Ownership of the river is a bit weird. You're free to navigate, but as soon as you drop a hook, touch bottom or pick up a mooring buoy, then Lord Montague, for it is he, will demand his shilling. I'd obviously been tracked coming up on the CCTV cameras, and within 10 minutes of picking up an empty mooring, a nicely spoken work experience boy came up and demanded money on behalf of Lord Montague of Beaulieu, a man who is so infinitely much richer than either of us that it boggles the mind. However, rules is rules, and as sailors we should obey them.